So this is the triangular distribution. It's one of the last ones that we'll look at. It is a continuous distribution, and the important things for this is that you know the maximum, the minimum, and the mode. And mode, again, is the most common value. So it is a continuous distribution. It's modeled in the shape of a triangle. The random variable will have, again, like I said, the min, the max, and the mode. And the probabilities are calculated by using the formula given to you. So we have a bunch of formula given to us on the formula sheet. It's all this scary looking stuff down here. But you don't have to memorize that, it'll be given to you. And we use that to find the height, and then we use the area of the triangle formula. And remember, area of a triangle is 1/2 base times height, but that is also given to you. Conditions for this distribution, you do need continuous data. It needs to be approximately triangular, so that should be kind of like a linear or straight line between the minimum and the mode and the maximum, with the peak at the mode. And it could just be given to you in terms of hints, like you're only told the minimum, the maximum, and the mode, but they don't tell you what distribution, so you might assume that you have a triangular distribution. So this is on the formula sheet for you. And one thing that I would suggest you think about doing, because some people will find this helpful, is put a line through that and call the f of x the height. Because once you find the height from that set of junk that I'll explain to you, you can find the probability by using the height that you just calculated and then using the base of the triangle. So you use this to find your probability will be equal to the 1/2 base times height. And the way this works out is that you can pick a value of x, say for instance here, and that I want to know the probability that, as an example of like babysitting, that she babysits for less than 4 hours or something. So pretend that that's the four. So what you would do is we're going to try to find the probability by finding the area of this particular shape here at our cutoff value of x, whatever that is. And so we need to pick which of these formula we're going to use. You can see clearly that if x is less than a, outside here somewhere, that the height on that part of the triangle is 0, because there's no triangle below a. And same, there's no triangle above b, which is why that's 0. And then there's this gobbledygook here that says a is less than x, less than, sorry, a is less than or equal to x, less than or equal to c. So this is when you are to the left. So to the left of mode, you're going to use this formula here, using x, a, b, and c, where a is your min, c is your mode, and b is your max. And you could have a different example. For instance, what's the probability that she babysits for more than 4 hours or something, everything above? And that would be right of the mode, or above the mode. So that's the one thing that you'll have to pay attention to when using this formula, is determining which one to use. Are you using the one below the mode or the one above the mode? So as long as you pick the right one, the letters will be in the right order for you, even though they look very similar. And what that calculates for you is the height at that value of x. So this formula here will give you how tall that point is there at the top of the triangle. And it would do the same for this one. It would tell you the height, the top of that triangle. And once you know the height of your particular triangle, like this blue one here, you can calculate the base, because that's, in this case, the distance between a and x. And once you know the height, 1/2 base times height out of the formula here. So 1/2 base times height. So it might look a little bit complex, but it's not too bad once you start using it. So the things that we do need to know, like I mentioned, the minimum, the maximum, and the mode, a, b, and c, and those will go into your formula. Your expected value for this distribution would be the mode. And key things to remember, it is, oops, that's the other version. This is modeled by a triangle. And the total area of that triangle should be 1 for all possible possibilities. So the formula is used to find your height and then the triangle at the desired value. So for instance, like we said, cut off, find the triangle for the parts that you want. And keep in mind, because this is a continuous random variable, the probability of an exact value is 0. So, for instance, the probability of x equal to 2 would be equal to 0, because you cannot have a precise value. It's not a discrete situation here. It would have to be a range of values. Now, this one is often paired up with binomial distribution when you're looking for the probability of something happening in a fixed number of trials. So, for instance, the probability might show me how long I have to wait for the bus, and I could find out what the probability is, but then I could use binomial to figure out how long on average I'll have to wait for the bus, you know, on 6 different days or something. So that's the basics of our triangle distribution. Remember, all this stuff will be given to you, all the formula, so let's just take a look at how it's actually applied.